Out of those years, would like that play?
Yeah, the
does
play
it stand?
Was fun. Yeah, the play. I was never a very good old person, but
you were never a good old person.
No, I wasn't a good old person.
Oh, all right.
But it
Now listen, I want you to go into a reenactment because we've got a sleazy shot of the Reverend playing up to an old teetotaler, okay? Can we get a wife in on this? Do you think we could create a little bit of jealousy?
Much like...
Yes, she's watching this closely. There's the wife. Tell me, Dave, who's the wife?
That's Kathy Hatton.
Kathy
Hatton. Now she's Kathy Lydon.
Right. Welcome in, Kathy. We're just asking...
We don't have to call him
We're trying to encourage jealousy. And you haven't taken your eyes off Jackie.
You've been jealous for years.
Tell me what you said of Jackie a little earlier. She was David's...
Old flame,
yes, David.
We were always very close.
I can't remember. We were.
David was very close to a lot of girls.
What other girls come to mind, Dave?
It was his cartoons, actually.
Oh, the cartoons got you in,
didn't it? Very nice cartoons. Right. I still have some. I should have brought them with me.
I still have
a lot of them.
Yeah. Listen, really? Why don't you just grab her? Really?
Yeah, I do. I don't have to because I've got him there.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
and I'm married, very happily married.
Well, I just wanted to start with a bit of scandal, okay? to get this off to a red-hot start.
You've done well.
Thanks, Mel.
What's going to happen is, anyone wants to smoke,
got to go to the toilet.
But don't put your butts on the floor, okay?
No. They go to the toilet.
Try and put it elsewhere. Because it's against the rules to do it these days, and I didn't even know that. It's been 10 years. So everybody have a good time, and I'll be back later. Thank you.
Karen Bell,
ding dong. Hello. And what was your claim to fame?
I squashed a spider in your Marx book that Glenn Edwards had out of a little jar that he had.
That's right.
Thank you, that's enough.
Was it a redback? What type of spider, do you remember?
A tarantula.
Thank you.
Something like that.
And are you married at this stage, Karen?
No.
No, still single and fancy free?
Yeah.
Right.
Got
close? Have you got close? Would be a good question. Have you got close to marriage?
No.
You say yes, you've left them in the aisle. Everybody knows.
Hey, listen, we go over to your other crime mate, okay? Nolan. Come on.
Yes, I've been to jail.
Have you?
Yes, I got out of Alcatraz last year.
I thought you had the makings of a good crib.
Yes, absolutely.
What are your memories of our classes?
The Russian spy and the whoopee cushion. We used to call you a Russian spy.
Yeah.
That's about as mean as we could get.
And what's this about whoopee cushions? What did you guys do?
Sharon.
It's getting quite Sharon moved.
With Michelle, letting whoopee cushions off in English.
Yeah. Did you know I had that peppy dolphin?
Mr. McIntyre.
Do you remember me yet, then?
Yeah. Yep. Okay, and this is Julie. How are you, Julie?
Good, thanks.
Keep them well?
Yes.
I mean, you haven't changed.
Haven't I?
No, not a lot. Not like some people, you just sort of look and look and look. You've done well.
Thank you.
That's a compliment.
Thank you.
Okay. Who else have we got here? Wait a minute, yes.
Marilyn.
Oh, it's fine. Marilyn. Oh, yes.
Yes.
At the top of the list, Marilyn Barlow.
Yes.
How have you kept over 10 years?
Oh, pretty good, pretty good.
Pretty famously, I take it. You look like you're dressed up for Hollywood.
Yeah.
Wasn't she always a stylish dresser, guys?
Yes, she was.
Even in uniform, she looked good. You haven't changed, Marilyn, greatly.
Oh, thank you, sir.
A compliment to you there.
Nice legs too.
Well, Sharon, eat your heart out. What else were there other assets? Have you got...
You were an inspiration to me. I'm a teacher.
What, Michelle? No wonder. No wonder Metherell was trying to chop out 2,000 of us. He didn't get you there.
Oh, dear.
Where are you teaching?
No, I'm only kindy.
Well, that's all right. I mean, that's real teaching. Anything that
we teach. The nice ones. I don't have those awful high school students.
Yeah, the worms that sort of put spiders in your mark books.
Yes.
Yeah.
Take it away now.
Who would remember this face? How many would remember Dave Prattis, do you think, Dave?
Unfortunately, Dave's not real real good at remembering his own face sometimes. So
yeah.
Probably something.
If you keep drinking that stuff, mate, you won't probably remember very much at all.
The only thing that keeps me
intact. Oh, it's G.I. Cordia. Sorry.
But on this auspicious occasion, I'd like to welcome all visitors and guests. Okay, go
on. Right, yes.
In particular, I'd like to introduce my good friend, Mr. Rowan Carl.
Mr. Rowan Carl.
Yeah, how do you do?
Pleased to meet you. And Rowan, you've got a few words to say to these people on tape.
Yeah, you just said that's as good as it gets.
Pretty off-putting.
Yeah, no. It's a great night, actually.
Yeah,
I've got quite a few of these. And, this is the most I've seen at one of these reunions.
Yes. Well, compared to last year, let's say. This seems a bit
But I've been to this about my fourth now.
Is it? Right.
Yeah.
Right. Fair indication of his age.
Fair indication of his age.
Yeah.
When was the last one again, Ron? 54?
I don't know. Well, I'm the oldest person here. Yeah. 45.
Well, the 60th reunion this year, and Rowan fondly remembers the first.
Right.
Actually, there's a lot of faces here I can place, but I can't place the names. You know?
Yeah. It just takes a little bit of
digging. People are really changed, yeah.
And then we've got our guide.
What's that?
Then there are some perennials who don't change.
Oh, there are some perennials, Julie Hockey.
Where is she?
There's Carol Maher somewhere.
Yeah, she hasn't changed a great deal.
No, I remember Carol.
Yeah.
And Brett Poitevin, who was in The Phantom.
Oh, yes. The Phantom. Hey, listen, mate, some memories of The Phantom. What prompted that, actually?
I don't know, but a person got eaten alive on stage turned into a skeleton.
The Capillary Brothers.
Monkeys did shit from the...
That's right.
Yeah, and Brett was a little boy, and now he's about, a mile high.
Good memories for these guys. I might catch up with Sean, is it? Sean Ford?
No, that was Brett. It's Brett.
The older or younger?
Oh, no, so many bloody Poitevins.
They breed like Thompsons.
so there's Brett here and old Saul Burgess. Yeah.
Right.
No, the old English class is here, but it's a very small English class that we had in those days.
Actually, you're going to do a roll check a little later.
Yeah.
Just so you
can see. Fishburne.
Which one?
Tim.
All right, reaching down now.
He's
Tim.
He's a Carl fan. He's got about as much hair as me.
And
more than you.
Thanks, mate.
Yeah, it's okay.
Oh, well, he's on the right track.
He's on the right track.
Yeah. Okay.
He's got a very interesting career.
Has he?
Yeah.
I might catch up with that.
Yeah. What career is it?
What career is it?
Oh, there's some incredible stories too,
Well, I have to catch you.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody. All right. How you going? This is all I'm doing. Is that a change, guys? Hey, come on, I'm not saying that to Ron or anything.
Look better.
Thanks.
Where's it going?
Excuse me, Mr. Dennis, are you all right? Notice I said yes, sir.
I'm impressed.
Thank you.
All right, well, this is what this time is actually a welcome to the evening. Everyone knows that this is our year 10-year reunion. Shut up!
Excuse me, we're talking.
Sorry.
It's not a classroom. Okay.
Well, basically what we wanted to tell everyone is to sit down because pretty soon we're going to start eating. And throughout the evening, everyone knows Brett. I don't know, most of you probably know me.
You wouldn't believe it, it's still a woman. Well, anyway, can you please sit down? Because I've got to say something and everybody's got to be set. on their sticks when we say, okay, thank you. Just need one more second.
Welcome to all of you, students and teachers, to the 1980 class reunion. And let's everyone have a great night. And this is really special to me, especially because I've been invited to stand here and act like a wanker in a microphone. So if you stay mind me all night, that'll be good. As well as Julie, she's looking really fantastic. And Mr. Akapala's got to do a roll call. So just sit tight, guys. Everybody's got to stand when he does this, okay? Now you've got to stand. It's not the army, it's just the way things happen.
Righto, we have here some declassified material. After 10 years, we feel it's safe enough to reveal some things that come from the rolls. I'll start with 10M1. We'll do a roll check very quickly just to see who's here and who's not. Michael Cox.
Yeah.
Alan Feeney. Now, if we went on like this, we'd probably get pretty bored, wouldn't we? Do you realise that this school has 6 rolls and 6 photos? And that makes up the sum total of what we know about Year 10, 1980. It's pretty embarrassing. We tried to find some gear for you for the reunion, and that's it. But you people here represent what 1980 is, and what I'd like to do is make an appeal. But before I do that, who were the best non-attenders? And I've got the rolls, so I know. I'm going to start at 10M6. Now you shoot a few names to me as to who you feel might win the award in 10M6. A name. Just shout a name out. Who do you think might have won in 10M6? Can't even remember who you had for a roll call to, which I bet. Who was it? No, yes. It is actually Michelle Brennan who won the award by first term, 23 days off, second term, 33 days off. By that stage, she was missing for a term. Third term, I don't know what happened. Blood came into her life because she only had 3 days off. Okay, go to 10-5, very quickly. You were out of takers on 10-5. You go to 10-5. Who did you roll to? Don't know. Didn't have 6. Okay. Ten and four. Brett? No, it wasn't. Do you know what it is? I've absolutely mucked this up completely. Because in fact, Roy Herman and Neville Evatt were 10-end ball. And Michael Hart won the 10-end ball. Hey! Is he here tonight? Is Huddy down there? He's not here. Oh, well. Let's get excited about Nubbin.
He's touring.
He's touring because he had 27 days off in the last term. That is, he came up to week 7 and we didn't see him after that. Righto. Yes, the non-attenders have got a way of not even turning up when they have to. Okay, here's something, a bit of trivia for you. Mr. Carey, on the 8th and 10th, 1980, claimed 3,471 absentees from his role group, probably on an excursion, he said. And then Mr. Dawes sent back his letter. Don't let this happen again, Twig, or else. He left that year and went to the back blocks of Orange. We've never seen him since. Okay. We go down to 10 in 3. Who do you reckon might win out in 10 in 3? 10 in 3? Carol Sykes. 9 days in each term. What I get you to see is that that was the worst. Lady in the pink. You got a Mr. Dennis there?
That's right.
Okay. What we call that a strategic truancy. She took a day off each week. 10 and 2. Who wins out on 10 and 2?
Mark
Hesburgh.
Mark
Hesburgh. Right, good guess. Sorry. Anyone have any other guesses on 10 and 2? It was Beth O'Cass. 34 over the year, 18 in the last term. And her rival was Christine Hull. Okay. She had a little bit. Okay, 10 and 1.
Good cook, actually. He knows how to cut meat, this man over here. And Dorothy.
Sorry.
Not for public consumption, I believe. All right. We've got some little categories and awards here to do next. And the first award we've got is the person who's changed the most since school. I don't know who.
What we're doing here is we've got Dorothy Murchie, Irene Fitzgerald, I'm sorry about the married names, but it's not on tonight, Donna Handyboat. Can you please go around and get this organised? Like, Irene, come on, think about it. You're the one that organised me and Robert all day. It's my turn now.
Yeah, so but what's going to happen is we've got all these different categories and those three ladies who were previously mentioned are going to come around and ask people at their tables to nominate people in the categories that they think fit these most aptly. The categories are the person who has changed the most since school, the person who spent the most time in the hallway instead of in the classroom, the person who spent the most time up the back smoking, biggest heartthrob of the form, and I believe there's a male and female category there. And the last one is the table with the best graffiti on it. Now, I think there's really bad tablecloths on there, and if you've got a pen you're meant to go for life, any graffiti you can do is will be appreciated. Hang on, there's a late update coming here. No, there's not a late update coming. They're just going to leave me out here to stand here and look absolutely stupid for a while. But what about a song or two? Anything? Requests? A shy one? Tapping? No?
It's really good when Julie gets up here because she doesn't know what to do. She gets really flustered.
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
By the way, ladies and gentlemen and teachers, notice I said teachers.
Yeah.
Desserts ready. So while this category movement's going on, can everybody have their sweets? Watch out, I'm getting busted by a teacher.
I've got a very important and serious announcement to make. Yeah, I'm armless, almost completely armless. 1980 was about the first year I arrived in this school, and some of you people are about the first class that I had in this school. You were in year 10 and I had you for personal development. You might not remember it, but I remember it very well. It was in room 4. It's a long time ago, but my memory of one particular lesson is etched in the back of my mind, and that's a long way back. Actually, there are a couple of memories. One I've already alluded to, and I'm not going to go through that again with Ms. Barlow. She can't remember, fortunately, but yes, I've been severely embarrassed ever since, and that's all I'll say about that. But this is a serious matter. I left room 4 to go into the staff room to get a piece of chalk. When I came back out, one of you people had stolen my watch. I remember it very clearly. Now, I don't know who it was. Yeah, but it was a silver watch. Left-handed.
It was gold.
It was silver. And ever since then, I have lived with being let down. It was a soul destroyer. I trusted you people, and you let me down. The worst part about it, though, is ever since then, I've had this stupid watch around the neck. And everybody says, what are you, a sports trainer or an athlete? I mean, is this an athlete's body, really? Apart from that incident, though, most of my memories of you are vague. But that's perhaps the best they should be. And I really don't hold it against you. Only I really would love to know who it was who took the watch off my desk. It's terribly embarrassing. Don't eat your dessert.
Oh. Folks, I've got another announcement, and it won't take as long as the roll call session. But I have other declassified information here. In my hand, I have all of the marks for 10XH1. And I'm prepared to lay them on the table here, and you can come down and pour over them, Susan Mann. Okay, Susan? Philip Smith isn't here. What a pity Philip Smith isn't here. And what I want to do is give you 2 awards. We're calling these the Decadent Awards. You've been away for a decade. I now have developed sufficient courage to award the historians of the mark book. Do you realise these cowards got my mark book and scribbled right through it? Okay, and the evidence is here. I table that information now. And these are the contenders for the historians of the mark book. 10XH1, 1980. Tracy, retire before it kills you, Elderton. People remember Tracy Elderton? No. Oh, well. Jackie, and she's here tonight. Essays are my favourite pastime. I just can't help myself. Too good. Okay. Tony. Dennis is able to teach the Cro-Magnon man period of history easily because he came from that time, Liebman. Everyone remember Tony Liebman? Jamie, history stinks. I love history, sure. Warner. I checked the handprint. He wasn't game enough to write his name. Natalie, see you later, mudguard. No. Now this bears explaining. I once came into class and they had this thing going around about mudguard. I said, what are you talking about, fellas? And they put it this way. You know mudguards, chromey on the top and shit underneath. Well, there you go. There it is. See you later, mudguard. Sue. I still won't speak in broad Scottish even in 10 years' time, Bill. And Sue, one of the best things I've done is history, man. And the winner is historians of the mark book. Who do we give it to? I think we give it to Jamie Warner, because he obviously got the first name in history. Come on down, Jamie.
Jamie. Jamie.
We have a luscious person too.
this award to Jamie Warner because he constitutes some of the more vivid memories of my life at Barrow High School. When I was particularly naughty in maths class one day, Mrs. Street decided to condemn me to a fate worse than death and move me to the seat directly in front of Jamie, where he proceeded to spend the rest of the year stabbing me in the back with a compass. And we proceeded to then have several fights which actually ended in physical confrontation. And there's also another notable memory of him, all violent memories I have of Jamie. He picked up a hockey stick and hit Michael Michael Hall in the head. And also I remember a violent confrontation with our illustrious Ron Carr, whereupon Mr. Carr stormed down to the front office and got Jamie's Year 10 school certificate and ripped it to shreds in his face. Jamie cried, and it was the first time we'd ever seen any kind of emotion from him other than sort of violent rage. So, Brett's got some violent memories about Jamie as well that he'd like to share with you. Hang on.
I know you're laughing about Jamie Warner because everybody did. This is a great moment in my MC movement. Does everybody remember Bong Bong? The race club, the meeting we used to have a long time ago before it discarded by council bullshit. I remember a time, this is when and before certain people got married or not married. Married, sorry. He just told me he's married again. Sue Manning's involved in this, if you don't mind saying. It's Once Upon a Time on a Hill in Bong Bong. Everybody enjoys getting drunk on top of that hill. Who gives a damn about betting? When it comes to Jamie and I, we had a great day that day. We were drinking, having a beautiful time. Sue wasn't real happy though, when I tell you what's gone wrong. Jamie and I had a nice, great little wrestle on top of the hill. And that was... We were both the same size and both the same weight. We had the same amount of little muscle. But I had a little bit more to drink than Jamie. And I threw him down the hill. And you would not imagine, when he got up top of this hill, he was whinging. And I hate it when Jamie whinges, because he always sort of sometimes he fakes it. But this time he didn't. Jamie had wounded himself in the arse. He cut his arse on a piece of glass. And Sue Manning belted living life out of me. She loved Jamie at that time. Anyway, it's back to Jamie. Jamie, you deserve this award. And also, I have to say, I'm sorry about telling you about that.
Just about to say something. I'm working here.
Stand up.
I'm a bit taller than you, Brett. That's one thing. I suppose I'll lift it up. A little bit speechless after that, I've been humiliated completely. That's probably one of the best days of my life, getting the arse cut open and about 12 stitches stuck into it. But they were mostly good memories there, but at school, but a lot of bad ones too. I couldn't wait to get out of the place. When you've got teachers like Mudguard and Carl and everyone up a certificate and everything. But it's good to see everybody back here, and we'll catch up with everybody later on. Thank you.
Thanks, Jack.
Very quickly, the second award for that same class is the Teacher's Pet. Teacher's Pet for 10XH1. We start with Tony battering my eyelids as a habit I have, Liebman. Tony, I'm not a Liebman Greenway. Remember that, sir? Natalie, I wouldn't give you the satisfaction of sucking up to you, Mudguard, no way. Alan, I need all the marks I can get, so here's 10 bucks handily. Jackie, I'm really as good as my name suggests, good. Alex, why should I try when I get the same result when I don't do my work? Please feel sorry for me, Gunny. And Susan, can I wipe the board or lick your hair back? And Philip, may I stay behind to revise this lesson? Salient point, sir. And could you send me some overnight assignments, Smith? Okay, Teacher's Pet of the Award, Pet of the Year, 10XH1 1980, and it goes to Susan Mann. And could you lick my hair?
I only know one story about Sue, and it was a fairly sad story. She had to have her wisdom teeth out, and she unfortunately had to keep coming to school after she had her wisdom teeth out. And she had a face about three times as larger than it used to be. And she wasn't on solid food anymore. And she used to bring in minced up sandwiches and a straw, because she could only just get them through. The only thing she could get in her mouth was a straw. But that's the only thing I can remember, the most memorable thing I remember. Other than that, she was really a good sort of student.
Well, here we go, it's her turn to talk.
I must have been one of the more mundane people before, because I didn't have a nickname. I didn't break people's school cases by jumping on them when people broke their rulers. I can't remember saying half of these things Mudguard said about me. I do remember when I did have my wisdom teeth out, Tim was there as well, and he had a face the same size, and we sort of walked around with faces, and we called each other Bugs Bunny because we had faces out here. I don't know how many people are still local, but you don't really get to see people very much. I mean, I was just across the corner from Joan, and we'd see each other about once every 3 months. It's really nice to see everybody here, especially the people that have travelled a long way, like Mick and Rod. Just thanks for coming, and I hope you all enjoy yourself.
Righto, in that year I had one other class, it was 10E2. Sorry to bore you with this, but we did play. 10E1, you remember, with Carly did. Return of the Phantom. 10E2 came in with a religious soapy called Reverse the Charges. Now what I'd like to do is offer golden bogeys for that variety night performance. The contenders. David, break an arm rather than a leg for dress rehearsal, Lydon. You all remember he popped his arm out like this. Amazing that he went on with it. Donna, don't I look like Dolly Parton without the assets Puttock? All remember that? Donna, I wish I had Donna Puttock's assets, let alone Dolly's handy bow. Narelle, looking like a loudmouthed old woman, comes natural, Taylor. Tracy, I didn't need any makeup for this Murphy's mustache, Elderton. Although you'll have to look at the photos to check these out, and they're on the back of one of the boards. Mark, these Mick Jagger lips are really mine, so is the lipstick forward. Jackie, can't I win one award? Good. And Alan, I don't need to look any cooler than I humbly allow myself to look without driving the girls wild. Feeny! And the winner of the Golden Bogey for that variety night award goes to Miss Good, because there is an award for you, Jackie. Finally. Well done, Jackie. You got her up? She's got to come up. Listen, can I just say, I've got other decadent awards here, blanks. If you'd like to give an award to some student or teacher, come and take one of these blanks, go back to the tables, work one out, bring it up. Okay? I'll put it down the front here if you want to. One of the decadent awards, work out the blank.
Tutor-wise, I've actually got something to say about Jackie Good. Yes, Jackie, I have. Mark Goodman isn't here yet. He's going to return in a dispossible manner when he gets here. When he gets here, you're going to know he's going to be here because he's going to roll a pirouette through the whole hall. But Mark told me about Jackie being very good about milking cows and losing it sometimes. She's lost her memory. She's 10 years ago. This is 11 years ago. Jackie Good was milking a cow by the tit, not with suction caps. And she'd missed hit this cow, and it had kicked Mark Goodwin where you reckon it would be. That's all I have to say.
No idea what he's talking about, but it is lovely to be here, and he had to get me on one award, so better this one than any other, I guess. Thanks.
Jackie has got no idea about what I'm talking about, but I'll tell her later. By the way, what we're doing right now is girls. Sorry? Oh, sorry. I got excited. Sorry. Has everybody got their dessert? Okay, get it. And I'll come back in 5. Little bit of music. Sorry, Donna's coming at me now. It's really slow. Like, me and Robert Decker were here this afternoon. As soon as I walked in, I had a hangover because I had a bad night with Mark Goodwin. And the girls just got me and Robert to do everything. Like as if we were their maids. Isn't that amazing? 10 years and you're still getting taught how to do things by a woman. Jesus Christ.
Donna just wanted me to repeat, apparently she's gone round to each table and given everybody a piece of blue paper, and I'm going to tell you each category again as soon as I find it. Okay, so just discuss amongst yourselves on each table and nominate somebody for each one of these awards. Number one category, don't discuss it for too long, bud. Person who's changed the most since school. Alright, I can't see much discussion. Everyone got their person written down there, nominated? I didn't change at all.
I don't know.
Person who changed the most since school. It was 10 years ago, it's a bit of a worry. No? Finished? All right, number two category. Person who spent the most time in the hallway instead of in the classroom. Carol Marsh.
No littering, Mr. Tim Blake, please.
Okay, the third category for nominations is person who spent the most time up the back of the school fagging? I think Rowan Carl wins the award for person who spent most time in front of a class bagging, is it? Okay, category four. The biggest heartthrob, female. Well, that's a very hard one. Is the biggest heartthrob male. Everyone's so quick. Did everyone just know who they had a crush on? Alright, the last category, oh you can't nominate, the last category you have to get busy because it's the table with the best graffiti. Alright, so eat dessert and we'll come back and figure out who won the nominations. Oh, you can't get nominated in the last category. You've got a
very serious condition. And we are lucky to have Anne here with us tonight and her boyfriend David Thorne, who is also here. Excuse my voice. For those of you that are interested, there is a charity concert tomorrow afternoon at Palmy's Woolshed. The admission price is $5 for adults. Now, we are hoping to have a recovery party tomorrow, but for anybody that would like to go to the charity concert to aid Richard Vince and his family, it's on from 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon to 5:30 at Palmy's Woolshed.
Getting sorted?
No, I just got my fader taken and I said, six! don't buy the paper.
Axel, Judy Schofield, David Sell.
Person who has most changed.
Glenn Green. Judy Schofield. David Sell and Glenn Green. They couldn't make up their mind on this table. David Sell.
Silly.
This one's on
the
David Sell. David Sell again.
David, you look like a sure thing here, Dave. Can we get a word?
Amazingly,
David, you going to do it?
Oh, no. I haven't changed everybody else has.
Tricking me. Okay, David Sell, would you like to bowl up here?
Come on, Sally, come on, Sally. David, baby, come on, baby.
Where are those long black locks? All right, here we go. Donna's going to present David with something for his effort. Does anyone know anything disgusting about David Sell? Brett Burton does. What a surprise.
I love his hair.
David wants to make a speech now. We're trying to hold him back. He wants to nominate his partner.
I haven't really changed. I'd just like to thank everybody for turning up and I haven't really changed.
Hey, David Sell's partner is... Start onward.
Michael Hutt. Leanne Maloney. Come on, Sloppy.
In the middle.
In the middle, Sloppy.
Come on, Leanne.
Philip Hilton, and he's not here.
Leanne.
Joan Harris. Joan. Get down. Kathy Drayton. Susanna Schmidt.
Woo!
Susanna's here, I saw her.
Come on, Susanna.
Leanne and Susanna, where are you?
Come on, Susanna. Susanna.
Come forward.
Please, in the middle. Susanna,
can I get
you?
Excuse me, Leanne and Susanna, please come down. You know how to do it. You've done it before.
And another nominee is Robbie Decker. I think I saw that. So, and another nomination for Robbie Decker. Robbie, where are you?
I'm Robbie Decker.
Lorraine Noble? Is Lorraine
frying.
All right. And the winner, Thor. Person who spent most time in the hallway rather than in the classroom, Lorraine Muddle. Dance partner. Oh, Lorraine, you don't have to
bagging. The nominations are Alan Handley. I don't think he's here. Jamie Warner. Jamie, come on.
Jamie Warner,
where is Jamie Warner? Ah, come on, Jamie.
Mr. Carl. Susanna Schmidt. Bad girl before. Quickly, Mr. Carl, get down here.
You and your partner get a free pack of cigarettes.
Boy! Lolly ones too. Excellent. You've got to hand it out.
By the way, now time's enough to take over this lollies.
That's good, mate. That's good.
Thank you.
Thanks everyone for coming. On behalf of the committee, I would like to thank everybody that came here. Everybody that helped this afternoon, because it took a lot of work. Everybody that helped the head editing. And anybody that wants to help tomorrow at 11 a.m. We're going to handle all the fellows if we can help to lift those big tables back in again. And I'd also like to thank Julie and Brett for being our MCs. Julie, Brett.
Bullshit.
Totally.
Brett. Oh, what do we do? Did we do something wrong? Oh, Mum, I don't eat chocolate.
Thanks. And if everyone likes to put their hands together, thank you, Julie and Brett. I think you've done a wonderful job tonight. Thank you. That ends the formalities of the night, so if everyone likes to just have a good rage, except they've just told me that we forgot one nomination, and that was for the best graffiti table of the night. So after that, it's time to party party.
If we we can have everybody to get their act together and do some more graffiti, like teachers as well, because they're always doing it in their notepads. Especially this bloke, Canberra Recycling, he's always been doing it. Thank you very much for coming. The committee, this is a big one. Dr. Murphy, sorry, but can I have Dr. Murphy, Donna, Dave Lou, Donna Lurie, Donna Chua, Irene, is it Decker? Robbie Decker. The Harris sisters. Elizabeth. Yeah. I want both the Harris sisters, please. Anyway, thank you very, very much. I didn't think I could do this, looking at all of these now. I'm sure I could have done it 5 years ago, but it doesn't matter. All the nominees of our category series, 1980, have to come up to the dance floor and get ready to have a dance. And don't be embarrassed.
Right, we're talking to Judy Scofield and David Sell. Okay. How's the night been going? Bit nervy, coming back. Yeah. Why so much? I'm going to have to come in a bit.
I don't know, I didn't want to come.
You didn't want to come?
Not really. I don't want to hear about it. What else is the bullshit? That's...
Yeah.
There's people here that I don't really see, so that's why
I like. Actually, I sense this, it's pretty hard to get 100 people to sort of come together after 10 years when you've got to get all on four corners.
It's very much so, yeah. So, you can take the people from a lot of things, and unless you see them regularly, it's kind of a bit of a
even just to come back and brush over the
years. Yeah,
that's right. Yeah. Well, what have you done with yourself?
Well, it's
okay.
When I
left on DVDs because college course down in Wollongong. Then I worked in Sweden for 6 months. And then I moved to Sydney and worked at CSI. And that's where I met my dad. And then I moved to Sydney and then went over to London for a couple of years to do a postgrad there. And then we came back and we've been back for 3 years. And now I work for the Hong Kong Bank.
I did 2 apprenticeships. Yeah. I did a carpentry apprenticeship and I didn't like that. So I put myself through painting and decorating and that was alright. And worked around here for a while by myself.
No.
Moved to Sydney, worked for a maintenance company in Sydney for 8 months and then I worked for a staging company. And started off there as a little person and now I've worked with these guys that did everything from Hamilton on Time to the football and all this stuff. I've been to Japan for work for Toyota. The work ran out because the money ran out because the government won't allow to go on much anymore. So promotion's gone down, so a lot of people lost a lot of jobs. Planning on, I've been back for a year. Not married. And I'm going to go to London in March to see my little sister.
Oh, good.
Is that all?
Okay. If this thing were to happen in 10 years' time, what would you charge? Or do you think you'd be here?
It's the front of the school, everybody.
10 years' time. Mm. Mm. The way that I've gone through life, I don't know. If I had the chance to come back, I probably would come back because I know that it would be totally different again.
What do you mean to come back to?
Well, that's come back to
20 years.
The 20 years.
Oh, okay. Yeah, great to come back.
No, that's it, everybody. I might even have
a girlfriend by then.
You might have a wife by then.
Yeah. Come on, Doc. We want to know how you feel the night's been going. Oh, come on. Is the night going well?
Come on, Doc. You organised it all. Come on, Doc. You can do it.
You can do it, Doc.
No, can you put on Doc?
We'll go straight to Wilma.
I think it's great seeing everyone after 10 years.
Yeah.
Especially Leanne and everyone who's married.
Leanne? Oh, is this Leanne up here?
Yeah.
Married one of our ex?
Yes, one of our other students. Yeah. Has 7 children.
7 children?
No, still going.
Still going?
I'm trying for 20.
What have you got? The Thompson disease. Get it, you have got 7 children.
No,
you're sure. Funny that I can hear jingle bells. All right, Donna, I'll go to you. Well, I can't go to Australia.
I'd like to know.
Well, how's tonight going?
Look, happy, I think tonight's going quite well.
Yeah.
I'd prefer to see everyone
up and
raging a bit more, like up and dancing. Yeah. The music lower so people can talk.
Yeah, actually, we've got a conflict of interest here because there are some who want to talk and others who want to boogie.
Yeah. I just like to see everyone having a good time. I think everyone is having a good time.
Yeah.
If everyone is having a good time, I'd be happy. Yeah. As long as they're having a good time, I know that we satisfy everybody.
Alright, now the mother of 7, Leanne, okay. How's the night been going?
Great.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, who's the person? Do you feel David Sell deserved a prize for the last change?
No, yes.
No, definitely not. Dot is about to speak. Okay. She's ready.
Judy Schofield.
Who is?
Judy Schofield.
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
What's she doing? Well, she was like originally a crane girl.
Yeah.
And now she's 13.
So it's Jenny Craig Schofield.
Yeah.
There it is.
Yeah.
Well, we'll have to find her and just sort of do a before and after comparison.
I think so.
Okay.
And David Searle, he's changed.
Yeah, but I'd like to reflect on the memory of a teacher.
Oh, yes. Let's go to the teachers.
Right. Your teacher I remember is Mr. Carl.
Go on, yes.
Mr. Carl.
I remember the best history lesson I ever had.
Go on.
And the most memorable history lesson I ever had was when Mr. Carl told us about all English customs when there wasn't enough women for men.
Yeah.
And then she came into it.
That'll be right.
Yeah.
And I remember explicitly the way that Mr. Carl told us how the women satisfy, the men satisfy themselves.
With soup.
When there wasn't any women to satisfy them.
It was an anecdote that he made up.
That is the most memorable history lesson I have ever. Come on,
okay. All right. Other teachers that you remember? Leanne. Oh, look at this.
Chocorelli.
Chocorelli. Why?
Plastic fingers.
Yes.
Okay.
Donna Potter.
Plastic fingers, Donna Potter.
Right, Leanne. You can put it all together. She's not here tonight. I think there was so much retail that Chocorelli wasn't coming.
Right. So Leanne, is that your reasoning? In a nutshell?
Yes.
Okay. Right, Sue, which teacher would you remember?
Well, I have to go to Mr. Top 32.
Yeah.
Story memories.
No, Sue must have story memories.
I have to go. A lot of story memories.
Your turn.
Okay. Wilma?
I mean, Mrs. Cheek.
Mrs. Cheek, yes.
Yeah. Oh, remember, Mrs. We asked Miss Cheek to come tonight.
Yeah.
She cried.
You remember that, didn't you?
Her guys sent her out crying. I think that was terrible. Now that you look back, it was so sad.
Right. You liked her as a teacher?
She was good.
What about Lippy? Lippy.
As in
Lippy.
Miss McLeod. She's actually teaching at a school up in
Sydney.
It's a girls' school.
I remember being in a magical group.
Who do you remember? There's another memory coming up. Ruby Lips.
Is she still around?
Okay. Your favourite teacher?
Thank you.
Bring your face around the camera.
Why is that?
She's the only teacher that sent me out of class.
Really? What was the occasion? Tell me about it.
I just wouldn't read a book.
Yeah?
So you sent me out.
Dorothy is talking in class.
She's always interrupt
Dorothy.
If we were to go for another reunion in 20 years' time, okay.
Five years.
20.
Would you make it 2010 or 5?
Time went by so quickly. 5.
I could have 50 kids by then.
50. Geez, 5.
Leanne will have them for me as well, I think.
Okay. She's going to sell the babies, okay?
Yeah. Leanne will bear them and
we'll make a fortune.
Yeah, well, it is a recession.
She's going to sell babies.
Yes. All right, guys. Well,
and I'll mark them for her.
It's so hard. You guys have really been finding it hard to say anyway.
One question. How much more hair will you have in 10 years?
Okay. Oh, that's cruel.
The ultimate plan is this, okay? And I'll get on screen for the first time ever.
All right.
My intention is, in 10 years' time, I'll have enough hair to my head in and I'll have a full lock of
hair. Tell you what they say.
Go ahead.
They tell me that if you want to use your hormones to grow hair, then that's fine.
Yeah. Thank you for that, Donna. I'll go away and replay that and see what it means.
I'll stop there.
All right. Well, thanks for your time, girls.
Thank you.
I'm having a great time this evening. Just a bit disappointed that there's not more teachers here to celebrate this.
Right. If there was one teacher, Anne, what would that... Not Anne, it's...
Sue.
Sue, sorry, Sue. One teacher that you thought made an impact on your life. First teacher that springs to mind.
Mr. Carl.
Right. Any reason for that?
No.
No? Okay, go across to Anne.
Hi, I'm Anne Skerritt. I was Anne Bennett. This evening's not been too bad. Could have been organised a little bit better, but it's been fun, I guess.
Right. What is it that you wanted to see a bit more of? Or time to just talk, inquire?
Yeah, I guess the music came on a little too quickly.
Right.
Lunged into darkness all of a sudden.
Right.
And you couldn't hear very well what was being said on the stage,
yeah. So there's a few comments. Okay. Now, if I just come back a bit, if there was one to be held in 5 years' time, would you be here?
That's a bit too soon.
Too soon, right. 10 years?
Probably 25
years reunion.
Right.
Yeah. We'll be later. Yeah.
You're not
talking, are you? No. We'll have to.
Come on, man, I said the back door.
Yeah, well,
the back door.
I don't use the back door.
Righto, where would you like to go first, guys? The science labs?
Yes.
The science lab. We might take you into lab one and we'll have a class, okay?
At the art room, coffee.
Okay, we'll go up top. Righto, into the labs. In you go.
In they go. No, a dreadful mistake, Dennis.
What's happening?
We're not letting them in there, are we?
Hey.
Stand in the corridor, stand up straight. Bloody fish bird. Get out of here.
With the plane, out on the
ground. I don't want to get in there and fix that PowerPoint.
Hi. It's
Hi.
Get a bike. Jesus.
Is there anybody left in the hall?
No.
This is our last
Donna was in trouble. That's what she was.
I would make sure you don't get caught.
And I was never in the corridor.
Is that right, Irene?
Yeah.
Irene, why does it feel strange? Hey, listen, is this a flash kill? I missed that.
Oh, sorry.
What's the focus?
I tell you what, there's a lot of women.
There's a lot of women as presidents, but there aren't as many women
vice president.
As vice presidents.
Because they don't have
some will still ask who wears the pants in their family.
We know.
Hey, Jules.
We do. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I definitely do.
Where to now, Mr. Leader? Where to now?
I think go upstairs. Show them.
Name up there.
The library. Nobody knows who that is.
Who went to the library?
wine. Not having that anymore.
Put up with that. There we are. Wait there.
Turn off the cameras, mate. Turn off the cameras.
What is that?
The flower rug.
Beautiful.
There's one each day.
Hey, Brumfield.
Brumfield, that was a female toilet.
You're a sick man.
Let's get this on camera.
What do you want to hear?
Now this used to
be like,
hey, this used to be
every second bloody day.
This used to be Stan Dawes' office.
Yeah, no, that's right. Stan Dawes.
And Stan.
And you used to have about, hey Robbie, come here, you know
all about it. You know all about it.
How many times? Stan used to give you a choice of sticks.
One time Stanley got Robbie Lee out here at a table.
Right.
And he had salt and rice.
Yeah.
And Robbie Lee had to sort out the rice from the salt.
That's it.
So Robbie Lee got a straw and blew all the salt away from the rice.
Well done. For the memories.
Stan used to keep the scoreboard on the back of the door for how many times you reported to him.
Yeah.
And after you reached a certain mark, he would drag out a cane as big as his fucking cane.
As thick as your dick.
And he said,
he's got my children.
Why don't you sit down, son? And some of these characters.
Decker.
He said you never hit somebody without hurting them, right? And he used a door.
The trouble is, Robbie, you used to love it. He loved it.
Yeah, I was in the same.
He used to get a
crop. I've got more and more.
Yeah. Give me again. He dragged my erection every time.
Think as you think.
This.
One more time.
We're last.
Are you?
You're leader. You're the leader.
I gave the job to Mike Dennis, okay?
But he's watering the plants. He's marijuana plantation.
That's good. Yeah, things have changed here. Everything's been legalised. Very happy students. Highest kites after lunch.
Well, you want to watch them, mate. There won't be many left with this bunch around.
Thank you. Do you guys know what's going on here? Could you give me some idea of what's happening?
It's the finest school I've ever went in.
Yes, who do you remember the mass bar?
Who do I remember? Dick Barrett was the street person. Oh, and Mr. Bree.
Just hang on, I've got to get this heavy breather.
I'm just trying to stick my tongue in
here. Oh, thanks, mate. You can't reach that.
You might go.
Okay.
I'm
going
to get you what I'm doing.
There's a few people want to see a girl's toilet and they're blokes.
Girls' toilets.
Mr. O'Neill's up with his chair trying to get you some on the car.
Hey, Sally. There's got to be a story in this.
Yeah, but you won't be able to read it because I've got a chalk.
What's the message?
It actually says, Mr. Street lives in brackets despite Jamie Warner.
Good message.
Because Jamie used to sit in that chair over there, and I used to sit in the one next to him, actually.
Right.
And Julie Hawk used to sit there, and Jackie Good used to sit in the front, and we used to harass both of them severely, and they just didn't like it much.
Right.
Mrs. Street didn't like either of us.
What do you remember of Mrs. Street? Just quickly.
Oh, she was a lovely person. She was so sedate and quiet, and she didn't really know how to handle us, but, you know, we're pretty obnoxious, I suppose.
Right.
But I think she went a bit deaf or something in her old age. I can't remember, but...
She had cancer, actually, behind the eyes. Yes.
But she was really nice. She was a really nice lady, and she was really good at maths. I mean,
right.
You know, and
And we really liked it, but we just didn't let on.
Thanks for that.
That was
my first time, yes.
You've actually been inside?
Actual virginal test for me for being in a girl's toilet.
Wilma, what are you going to do to this guy?
I feel disgusting. Like I've been intruded.
Oh,
it's an intrusion.
You can't respect a guy that's been in a girl's toilet, can you?
I can't respect him at all.
But it's too late. It's absolutely too late for it.
I'm his friend.
Oh,
oh, oh no! A gynecologist too! You won't respect him in the morning, I know. Barely have.
Smell. Everyone's familiar. Smell is like remembering.
It would have to be.
Where's Miss Hood?
It smells like the Danny Dolan prawn trawler.
That's true. She's a honey. And Miss Lott.
Now listen, the art rooms. Let me tell you about the art rooms. The art rooms are now.
They're upstairs.
In the new way. Now we now have a dance and
how come the building still
studio.
Smells
Miss, the
like
ghost of, the ghost of Miss Hood.
The ghost of Miss Hood.
Industrial arts.
Alright.
Yep. If anyone wants to know the ghost of Miss Hood, ask Dave Pratt.
I think he had a thing.
What's this? What's this? I'm onto something.
Quick.
Is this a story? A scoop?
It's a scoop.
It's a scoop. Dave Prattis knows something. That's a scoop in itself.
About Miss Hood.
Of what?
The stories that we can tell about Miss Hood.
Miss Hood? Who's Miss Hood?
This was Miss Hood wearing
socks. Anne Hood before you. Before your time.
Before my time, yes.
A wonderful teacher.
Wonderful teacher.
Miss Hood.
She had the distinction of being able to park her car at the front of the school, leave her car, sign on for work, and then unfortunately her car ran down the school fence.
That's it.
Trashed it.
Killed
it.
What a
word. One thing I've always wanted to ask. She always says the car started all by itself. We always say that.
Would you shut up?
I'd like to know if you turn that off. Did Mr. Mangwaring really wear a toupee?
I knew it.
It's real.
What do you think you're talking about?
We tried, but it's time to get it off him.
Yep.
Come on, get it off.
Is this embarrassing, Donna?
Yeah, it's dressed. Turn around.
What's happened, Wilma? What have you done?
It's all right.
It's okay. Capshaw, it was buried by whom?
Andrew McKelvey was in charge of it.
Andrew McKelvey?
Yeah.
It wasn't Andrew McKelvey, was it?
It is so Andrew McKelvey.
It's not Andrew McKelvey.
It's Andrew McKelvey.
Get out of here.
It is. And he was in charge of it.
What? Yeah.
And he,
It's John McKelvey, your dad.
It isn't. It's Andrew.
It
might have been John.
It was John. Hey, I talked with
it's John McKelvey, okay?
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah, he was in charge of it.
Yeah.
And he sort of rounded a few of us up and took awful photos. Sue might have been in it. Took some photos of us.
Do you remember this, Sue?
What are we doing?
The time capsule. Do you know when they're going to open that?
Is this science?
Get out of there.
It sure is science. Look at the teacher's notes on the board.
Hockey, get out.
Yep. Hey, listen, what about Sue? When are they opening that up? Do you remember? Was it 25 years or 50 years?
I thought it was the year 2000.
Alright, she reckons the year 2000.
I thought it was before that because I thought, I'll be pretty young then, but 2025 sounds a bit.
Yeah, well, you'll be in the grave, won't you?
I'll probably be dead by then, yeah.
You'll probably have
Especially after January the 15th.
We'll have to go out there and do a reconnoitring of dates, shall we? Listen, who is this tall guy? I mean, I keep wondering. Come on, you don't even remember this day.
My name is Alan, and I used to be a pupil at this school.
Really? He's not going to tell us anymore.
I'm still here, I'm alive.
Right. He's not an escaped convict from Berrimah after all.
Yeah, I could be. Can't release that.
How's Reg? How's Reg doing?
Oh, he's wonderful. Actually, no comment.
Sorry. No comment. Okay. You impressed with this, Irene? You'd always love to be a science teacher.
No.
And listen. There's a curiosity here. This man here, Julie's husband,
friend.
He's amazed that he comes into a science lab and it turns on a gas tap and...
It's on.
It's on.
The gas is on.
Now, if you'll leave the Professor room, I'd like to leave my life quietly.
Right.
Click on that gas.
No, he came from a deprived school and they could only have the gas very sparingly.
Oh.
And so they used matches.
Was this shit?
Chevalier, that was where it was.
It's a gas fire.
Actually, over there, they had to produce it first, didn't they?
Yes.
Get the chemicals right.
It wasn't very hard, though. They just sort of had a few people over there that could produce it naturally, I heard.
Oh, yes.
Modeling.
Yes, that's right. They used to plug in from, you know, some hidden resources.
Hidden teaching resources.
Excuse me.
This man. Sorry. Who is he? He's giving... Ah, Dick, you'll be... Answered or not?
Ten.
Ted Dixon, I thought. Yeah,
as far as...
All right, what is happening here?
Sorry, this is the secretary. Oh, shit, better hide the secretary.
The secretary?
Sorry, I don't think you are worthy of this school's report.
Is this a Stan Dawes lookalike?
As far as science teaching goes, we're fine at the moment. Oh, well, I'm
sorry.
Yes,
sorry, I was late on
Listen, is this Mr. Kavanagh applying for a job again at Barrow High?
Yes, a freshman.
Again? Didn't you hear? He was put away.
Yes.
Away.
Is that the blokes a pedophile?
Pedophile?
Oh, kids, I love kids.
Yes, it is Mr. Kavanagh.
It is like your biology is your better study. You just play that all the time. You say, biology, kids.
They're beautiful. You don't know kids in bed.
What's going on here?
Someone's beeper's going off.
It's all right.
No, it's not. It's not my
life. It's my pacer.
It's my secretary. It's not my secretary. My secretary's not here. Sorry.
Hello, is this the secretary here?
No, it's not.
Or should I say that one?
Sorry, no,
it must be Dobby.
Okay, well, thanks for that.
No worries.
What's this revelation?
What's this do? Tim Gorry, he kicked out a share for firebombs.
For firebombs, Tim? No? No, it wasn't you. Was
No,
like
turn the camera off. Sorry.
Turd, a revelation.
Come on.
Apart from getting exile from share.
I saw it.
Let's get it from the horse's mouth, okay? What did he used to do?
Okay, Miss Horse.
Come on, Miss Horse. Come on, Mr. Egg.
Tim,
Mrs. Egg.
Look at this.
Ms. Egg.
He used to get put mirror on his shoes.
Shoes.
And stick his feet between.
Yeah.
And tell you what color his hat was.
Mr. Holproof, we'll call him from now on. Tim?
Well, apparently.
Just between. Please don't touch it.
Just between you and me.
Look at Andrew. Look at Andrew.
It's just a model. He blows it up. Come on, let's get back onto me. Let's get back onto me. Forget Andrew. That was poster. I mean, we're talking about 10 years ago.
Bastard, put that down. Sit down. Go on.
Andrew.
Tim.
It doesn't blow up, mate. I've got some bad news for you.
Two.
Fishbone.
Alright, this will warm up.
Where have you been in the last 10 years, Tim?
I bummed around for a while after school.
Right.
Put it mildly.
Where'd that take it?
Wasted some time. I worked out at the book factory at Mossvale. Right. We're in Collins. Did some labouring out there for 10 months. Enjoyed myself. Worked with a lot of women. I went from there to the railway. Became a train driver, every boy's dream.
Yeah.
Drove trains in Heathcote for a year.
Which trains were these?
I wasn't actually a driver, I was the second man on the engine.
Right.
When I was at Heathcote, it was all goods.
Yeah.
Working on electric locomotives plus diesel locomotives. I was at Heathcote for a year and I came back to Mossvale, transferred to Mossvale Depot. Stayed there for 3 years. I went with passengers in on freight trains here, but it was all diesels there. From there I went to the police force, and the smallest thing I've been to end of the New South Wales police force. Still in here.
Yeah. How long have you been there?
2.5 years I've done in the police force now.
Right.
2 years general duties in Asheville.
Right.
And now I'm a member of the Elite 10th District Anti Theft Squad.
85th?
Yes.
And whereabouts are you based?
It's called F District, which is Ashfield District.
Right.
We sort of cover from Strathfield through to basically through the Dulwich and Marrickville.
Right.
Other suburbs are included in the area, those suburbs, Ashfield, Summerhill, Battlefield, Fire Dock, Burwood, Infield.
Right.
So there's 7 of us in our squad and we do whatever goes. We just wear jeans and t-shirts, shorts, whatever we want. do whatever we want.
There was that recent revelation of sorts where they were saying that New South Wales crime rate or rate of sold is so deficient compared to other states.
Yeah, true. They do say things like that in the media. I couldn't honestly say with figures that when you compare Sydney to the other major cities in Australia, well, the crime rate's higher anyway. Yeah. So you know, and you've got the same amount of police to combat that crime. So,
so
it's
relatively, you're doing
relatively
well.
You can see, it's alright. Okay. I can say for myself that in the other unit we do alright.
Yeah.
Try pretty hard. We're all young blokes and raccoons, so we like going out and locking up bandits. That's basically my job. Do a lot of drug busts, raids.
Yeah.
And anything else that's sort of happening at the time, any urgent jobs that come over here.
Right. How do you find, I mean, the amount of corruption up when you're on the...
Police corruption?
Yeah.
Is, of course, there's police corruption. There's a barrel up on every barrel.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'd be a liar if I didn't say that.
Yeah.
Basically, it's very petty stuff.
Right.
If you get up into the higher ranks, you could probably say that blokes that are way up the chain have probably done something to get there or know someone to get there.
Mm.
You've got to be hypothetical about that. Yeah. That's the way it is.
Yeah.
You know, you've got to buy your way to get a lot of places. It is changing now where you've got to go through a lot of courses and uni courses and things to get anywhere now, but bosses that are there at the moment have all bought their way there. So.
Well, that's the present. If we go back to the past,
yep.
What memories do you hold of this school? Are they
good? Barrel High School?
Yeah.
Well, I was a punchy little bugger. I was always getting in trouble for fighting.
Really? What was that back to?
Oh, right. You're 7, you're 8, you're 9.
Yeah.
I wasn't here in year 10.
Right.
Believe it or not, so I'm a bit of a shock being here tonight.
Right.
I was at Chevalier College. Dad sent me there for a little experiment.
Right.
So I kept getting out of trouble.
Right. Well, did you have to fight the fight for your father or something? Was that
no
problem, or?
I did have problems. So my older brother Paul, he was there.
Right.
The kids that we'd never seen before in their life would get in trouble from Dad.
Yeah.
Everybody would know that's been you from that era or whatever.
Yeah.
He was a pretty strict teacher, and you get give someone a cane or something in trouble, and the next day or a week later, the kid would come up and, you know, fish them, aren't you? Yeah. And then go from there.
What was the longest suspension? Did you ever get suspended for the
year? No, I never got suspended. So no, it wasn't bad fighting, just the usual scuffle or something.
Right.
So we'll just pick up paper types and
That was your reputation around the place.
Well, it wasn't a reputation, but it was just one of the things.
How did this form? Who were the people that were the big names? As you
big names? Brett Porter, for example. David
Storm. Yeah.
Saul Burgess. So they were the gang.
Were they?
They were a new gang at the time.
Right.
As for the girls, I don't remember any big names. Julie Hockey was always very well known, very popular.
Yeah.
She's a name I like to do.
Okay. Well, if there was a reunion to be had again, would you do it this way or would you change things?
I like doing it this way. I haven't been to any other reunions of any other sort. So this is good. So I don't know if there's any better or not.
Right.
But I think this has been very well organised by the persons that have done it.
Yeah, it's a compliment to
them. Yeah, it's been, you know, it's good to have you around the school and see what's changed. And, a couple of people to have a bit of gumption and get up and have a talk about different things that have happened. It's just basically good just to see people that you haven't seen for whatever number of years.
Right. How many years do you reckon should go between such things?
I reckon 10 years is a good number. I know someone went to a 5-year reunion just recently.
Yeah.
And I don't think the effect was as good as it was over 10 years from there to now.
Okay. Well, Tim, thanks for talking to us.
No worries, thank you.
Appreciate it.
Ash, 10 and 1.
Oh, don't.
Oh, no way.
Am I supposed to say
I've just completed a degree in human movement at University of Wollongong.
Right. Human movement?
Human movement. That's sports science.
Do you want to explain that?
Yeah, sports science.
Oh, the Marsh tradition.
Fitness.
Yeah, Marsh tradition.
Yeah.
And I intend to do my honours next year in Sydney. And
you're not enjoying this, Mark, are you? I can tell that. Yeah.
And then after that, I've been offered a scholarship for my Masters in America, and I'm also doing sports marketing in Sydney. I'm pretty busy, really, and I don't really want to go to work ever.
don't you? No. That's why you're into sport.
Yes. Well, that's why I'm into university. I'd like to...
Oh, university is an absolute...
Learning.
Right. Yeah. Learning. You become a perpetual student.
Come on. Look, if any of you are watching this and you want to know what to do with your life, go to university.
Righto, Mark. Do you want to go to university?
No.
You don't? We'll flash to you. Well, Carol, are you finished yet?
Well, I know you can go on forever. I'm sorry, you can move on to someone else now. But just to say that university is the time of your life. You've got to do it. You've got to experience the people, the alcohol, the,
Well, there you go, Mark. That might be the thing to start up on.
Yeah.
Where have you been, Mark, in the last 10 years? Taking honours degrees at...
No, I've just been bumming around, mate.
He's been going to the University of Life.
Yes, well said.
Okay,
yes.
That's just as important.
Yes, okay. Well, where have you been bumming around? In Queensland?
Australia.
Been around?
Around Australia, yeah, I've been around Australia.
Right. Which part of Australia impresses you most?
Geelong. Spent 6 months there, worked there.
Where's WA.
4 hours
long. Oh, okay, sorry. See, I'm ignorant of these facts and I'm...
Geraldton, is it?
Western Australia.
No, Geraldton.
Oh, right. Sorry.
I thought Geraldton was in Western Australia.
Yeah, it is.
Not Perth.
Okay. What made Geraldton so good for you?
The winner.
See, now you could go to university in Perth.
Can I just tell you something?
Yeah, go on.
When we were in year 10, I went out with Mark for 4.5 years.
You're joking.
He has the, he's so insensitive, he can talk about all the women.
Yeah.
I mean, that's really rude.
I just said it was...
Yeah, that's 10 years ago, Carol.
Yeah, I'm sorry, that was 10 years ago, okay? Yeah. But I haven't talked about all the men.
Oh, well, you could actually make him blush, could you?
I could.
Well, I didn't ask you to come in here.
Yeah, well, no, you didn't, but
I
did.
You don't talk about women.
Okay, let's not have a domestic
audience. I'm sorry.
Okay, Mark, so Geraldton was good.
Sorry, you
didn't
say
anything. Yeah, it was terrific.
Right.
Yeah.
How did you keep your body and soul together as you went around? Worked?
No, I went around Australia and we stayed there for about a week. And then I come back home and just decided to go back over there.
Right.
So three of us went back over and just stayed there. Got work, hay contracting, and it was great.
What about mine and work over there? That's big in WA. You ever get bit tired?
Yeah, I never
applied
for old work in the mine anyway.
Right.
He's an outdoor person.
Okay. Much like a sporting marsh,
well,
okay?
Well, sort of.
Yeah.
I'm more a thinker than a doer.
Mark, can you handle this? You went out with this girl for 4.5 years. What was going on?
She's a doer.
She's a doer.
Sorry, Rob. I think I better get out of shot. Let's pan across.
Okay. You're on.
What do you want to hear, Mr. Oakwell?
Well, I just want to know where you've been, what you've been up to.
Well,
it's great, cool.
Well, at the moment, I'm driving trucks, which I really enjoy doing.
Right.
You know, I was all that right at school, which doesn't mean a thing, really, when I get out there and have a go.
I agree.
I enjoy life.
Yeah.
Play a lot of sport.
Right.
First grade hockey team, goalkeeper, thank you. Enjoy.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Heaps of awards, love it. Yeah, I don't want to base too
very
much.
Very modest, yeah. Okay. But, and when are you playing for Australia? Chances
well,
are?
Hopefully 2 years, hopefully.
Hopefully?
Yeah.
You play rep?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is this bull or am I detecting that he's telling me honest things? Carol, tell me.
Is he that good?
It's a bullshit artist.
Do you reckon that?
Maybe he needs to go and do a little bit more training.
More training? I mean, this is the body of a fit...
That is your season, right?
This is the body of a fit Australian future goalkeeper?
Yeah, but you don't get on the profile.
Are you a goalkeeper?
Yes.
Oh, well, hang on, I take it back. Well, let's stop you better.
Need agility?
Yes.
Strength?
He's got those.
Fast reflexes?
He's got that.
I think that maybe he has all that.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, well, that's your sporting.
That's a nice, neat little package.
Okay. All right. How has tonight gone for you guys?
Good, bad,
or indifferent?
Quite a few little suspicions about tonight, but since I come in late with the gun under my arm,
I'm feeling better all the time.
Makes a difference.
Yeah, Mark would have maybe carried the cart in too.
Is that right, Mark?
Mark's lately purchased a nice little sports car too.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, very nice car.
Sports car, mate.
Yeah.
What? Mini Miner.
Yeah.
Better than mine, anyway.
Yeah. Too dodgy.
I think tonight was it was just seemed that people hadn't changed that much.
Yeah.
But, people are still the same, but
they're just a little bit more mature. And
yeah. Who do you feel has...
Yeah. Beth, the only girl I'm really surprised with would be Brett Gordon.
Why?
Well, that school is very frail, little fella.
He's bulked up a bit.
Now he's
like,
amen, big, Arnold, look out.
I think there's a lot of girls who've maybe had experiences like children and stuff that a few of us haven't, and we've been left behind a bit in that department, but there's other things.
Like life. University, boys, partying, yeah, why not?
Yeah.
Okay. If
you're gonna... like pointing that on me, don't you?
No, we would never have you in.
Can we get a Shelby shoes under $23 worth?
$23 shoes.
Julius Marlowe?
Bit of a bargain.
$23.
Very
well, you managed to pick those up for $23. You gonna give away trade secrets?
No,
they're
$123 worth.
Yeah, $123.
We can lay in front of that $23,
yeah. Oh, right. You're just
very, simple. Very, very nice.
Okay. Well, we're fast coming to a point where this conversation going in a circle, so let me just bring it to a conclusion.
Okay.
What do you say to the organisers? Anything?
I think they've done a wonderful job.
Right.
And I think a lot of people didn't realise how much other people meant to them until they get back with them again 2 years later.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, also it's a very good night. It's good to see everyone.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, very nice evening. Totally enjoyed it.
Yeah.
And look forward to the next 10
okay.
years.
Yeah.
10 years? Right. Yep. Okay, well, thanks for your time, fellas.
Okay, bye-bye.
This is Jackie Cram, for those that can't remember, because she's changed so much, a la David Sell.
I think she's changed for the better.
Have you? Do you think that's true?
Definitely.
She's changed for the better.
She was always
is this a proposal?
Really, really intelligent girl.
Yeah.
Who I thought was, oh, she's so intelligent. I was really jealous of her because I just wasn't anywhere near her league. Right. But she is
Jackie,
a really lovely lady.
Are you taking this in?
Yes, I am.
What is he doing, licking your boots?
Yes, what's he, what, yes.
Well,
like,
but I mean, you know, the difference was that I was never attracted to her at school.
Yeah. And tonight something's happened, obviously.
Oh, I'm not saying that anything's changed, but, you know,
okay.
There's always a possibility.
Okay. And they're going to the pub, I don't know where this could lead. Okay, Jackie, where have you been in the last 10 years? Just briefly.
Most of it at uni.
Yeah?
One of these professional
students.
No.
The government's all getting it. About time everybody thinks, really, I think. Yeah,
okay. I did
like
my
this.
Engineering degree and I finished it. And then I went to Cobar. So I've been in Cobar.
And who have you been hooked up with your engineering? Have you gone in with a government job?
No,
or?
No, a mining company.
Cobar?
In a mine.
What are you mining out in Cobar? What's that?
Our mine's mining lead and zinc.
Right.
But there's a copper mine and a gold mine as well.
All sorts of things in Cobar.
Right.
It's out of the sticks.
No.
I mean, they've got to have something going for them out there.
Right. Okay. So that's where you've been and what you're up to at the moment.
Last
okay.
3 years, yeah.
All right. Well, we're going across here to Mr. Green.
Oh, this is me. I've been... I didn't really qualify for this because I was only here for the first couple of weeks of year 10, so that's probably one of those roles out there.
Yeah.
But I went to Narella and then to Orange, which is my parents are there. And then I've been to RAF 8 years.
Right.
And I'm leaving 3 weeks, so.
Because you could end up in the golf? No?
Oh no, they can call me back apparently. That's a bad news. I thought I could get out. I'll get back
right.
and get scot free. But apparently they could call me back, so I've lost out badly. So but yeah,
so
you've
been,
I'd recommend the forces to anyone.
As a flyer or?
No, I'm a supplier, so. Flight lieutenant. I've had a really good time for RAF.
Well, where are you going with your RAF? Because lots of people go from RAF into private flying. I mean, it's a stepping stone. You've got
flying,
that in mind?
But I'm not a flyer, so I can't do that. But,
well, what is a second lieutenant?
Flight lieutenant.
Flight lieutenant.
Captain. Army equivalent captain.
Oh, right. So just an officer, is it? Or
just a
grand.
Yeah, I'm just an officer. I often aspired to be an airman, but I never quite made it.
Yeah.
No, but it's...
you've seen Top
really
Gun
good.
And A. Well,
you know. God, I was like a little like Tom Cruise. But no, it's been good. And it's great to come back to Bower. Bower's always been close to my heart.
Well, does that mean that you came to Barrel from another school beforehand, that you didn't go with these kids for a primary?
I came to Barrel in halfway through about sixth class, I think.
Oh, right.
My dad's a farmer, so we didn't do heaps, you know.
But the only friends I've retained from school have been Barrow ones. I've got two really close friends. And then
did you hear that, Jackie?
No, Barrow.
It's got two really close friends.
I'm not one of them. Aren't you?
Jackie's not one of them.
After tonight, we could have a revision on that. What do you want to say to the people who organised tonight? Have they done a good job?
They've done a great job.
I think I think particularly Brett and Julie, outstanding job out there. I mean, they must have been nervous. I would have been nervous in front of that many people, but I think they did really well. It looked like they've done it for years.
Yeah.
Great.
So they should have their own tonight show? Maybe?
No. Well, maybe their own midday show or something.
Yeah. Move over, Ray Martin. Anything that did change? Make advice for the future? For example?
Years. What about this night?
I think for our 20 years, I think they should...
Another venue?
Oh, no, the venue's fine.
Yeah?
Is the venue's okay? I think the venue's fine.
Is it a bit tacky, Jackie? I can see tacky written all over your face.
No.
Would you like it down a coal mine?
It's a bit big for the group of people.
That's true.
So
it is a bit big. It is a bit big for us.
Actually, it is. Yeah. Yes, actually, that's true. But then again, 20 years' time, you will have your children here.
For our 20s, if we have a 20 years, it'll be... I know we'll all be pretty old then.
Old?
We'll probably have a few wrinkles.
Well, you'll be in your 30s. Stay.
Maybe, I don't know.
36, I'd make it out.
35 gives us a break. We're not that old.
Well, you're not Keith Dawson, okay.
Yeah, we're 25 now. I just hope that when they had the one in 10 years' time, they don't show any videos of tonight.
Oh, no, that was me just
saying. I hope I'm not here. And I hope they do show this.
Anyway, thanks for your honesty and candid.
Where have you been in the last 10 years, Kev?
Barrow.
You haven't left town?
No, I was going to move about 2 years ago, but never got around to it.
Right. And what have you been doing at the time?
Work-wise.
Yeah.
I'm plastering.
Right.
I've been married. I am married and I've got a son. About 2 years old. That's it.
10 years old?
Two.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I was going to say, you've been a fast worker.
Not really.
And how's business good at the moment, or
picking
up again?
Yeah, it's slowed down a little bit and still playing about that.
Right. You didn't ever work with David Sell in the years?
No.
Or Sell's as his father?
Colin. No.
What's your own business and such?
I did have, but when I was leaving town,
Right. Who's that with?
Some Islands and Jerry's.
Okay. We go across to Neil. Neil, you want to tell us a bit about yourself in terms of where you've been in the past 10 years?
Working down in the National Bank down in Queanbeyan. Worked down there for about 12 months.
So you've been in bank since you finished school?
Firstly, ever since I finished school. Except for about 5 months working for Rob Irving, cutting glass and stuff like that.
All right.
That's about it.
Okay. When you think about tonight, guys, have you enjoyed tonight, or did you come with a bit of hesitation? You know, or do you think it was a good idea right before you go?
I thought it was a great idea.
Yeah.
I really looking forward to it. I thought everybody really should turn up.
Yeah. Right. Has it lived up to your expectations? Do you think it's worked? Especially from 1082, we've got quite a roller.
Yeah.
I think we've got one of the better classes represented. But then again, we went to one last year, the 1979 year team. And they were disappointed as well. Just a lot of town people that could have been here just go for the big flick.
Most of the same as the 90s.
Say to the organisers, just you've got any comments?
Land have done a good job. It's not something you want to. It's alright for us to just turn up, have a night and say it wasn't good or it was good.
I'd say that.
There you go, say good on.
Thanks, they've done a good job.
Well, actually, So they're special people, aren't they? Because they're special people, you're going to be on the line.
That's right.
Okay. Well, thanks for being part of the video, eh? And thanks for giving us a catch-up on the last 10 years. Hint at 7, talking with Alan and David, ex-10E2 students. 10E2, yeah. There are guys that come in and bit and hurt themselves about being 10E1, but what was it like being 10E2 and nipping at the heels of the upper echelons? It was a good life.
I enjoyed it. Looking back, I think it wasn't bad.
Alright, you're not going to be jealous of people, so you couldn't reach out a degree of get down there where you live.
Well, it's not, it's certainly not the same sort of not pressure, but because you're only top classes, you don't feel that you have some good city, doesn't it? I mean, that's all about it.
Did you have any aspirations of being 10-1 material?
Or, no.
Well, 10E2 is usually full of guys that should be in 10E1, but slackened off somewhere along the line and ended up in 10E2.
Mate, never slackened off in your life.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, where have you been in the last 10 years, Alan? You've been in cars today?
Well, let's go with the Smith Works.
Right.
And then, 3 years ago, I went up to Brisbane, Rexburg. Next day, travelled around Australia for about 6 months. Then out of Kalgoorlie, came out for the last 18 months. Just got back a couple of weeks ago. Then fly out to London on Boxing Day.
Out to London?
Mm.
Why London? What's up? Just a holiday?
No, it's indefinite.
Indefinite?
Got an open ticket. See what happens from there.
Well, hang on, you're both in England, are they? Or?
No, they're Scottish. Oh, they're over here.
Oh, you wouldn't be trying out for, say, Liverpool or Manchester United, would you?
Well, I remember about a few years ago, George Best got pretty
good at bowling,
like I got, so...
I
reckon
I'd
have been Manchester
United.
Yeah. You
still playing soccer,
Alan? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, when I was over there, Ken Bell won the grand final in the league. Won the league for the first time since 1972 and the grand final for the first time ever.
Yeah.
So, I was quite happy. I had their players in gear and got a lot more out of that.
We'll go over to David. You want to tell us where you've been, David, in the last 10 years?
Still living here. I've done the apprenticeship. Got married, got work in probably 3 or 4 different jobs. I'm employed as a planner now in a manufacturing business. It's hard to say, I mean, looking back 10 years has gone really quickly. Yeah, walking around here you can see how young we were and how silly and stupid. And it's amazing how much you don't know when you think you know it all when you're 16.
16. Most people are saying they're only 15, 25 now. Yeah. So you're one of the old ones, eh?
That's what amazed me. I'm out there looking at some young skinny girls and some bunch of old girls.
All right, what would you say to the people that have organised tonight? Have they done a decent job? Do you feel it came up to expectation?
Yeah. Oh, it's good. It fits more than I expected, I think.
Is it?
Never been to a reunion before. You always think of the ones you see on television, but usually, pretty pleased with it. There's a lot of people that I had totally forgotten about, which is good to see. And ones that I have got to see have been here.